immediate problem to that annexer. And the second thing is, it is not accessible, but it is permeable. It goes to other regions. And ubiquity means whatever that happens, as per the principle of universality, as well as global consciousness, anything that happens conspicuously or even inconspicuously in some other part of the world, that will certainly reflect, either immediate reflection or remote reflection, tangible reflection, subtle reflection, whatever may be the type. Apart from the spatial, temporal and tangibility modifications, the impact of each and every happening at any corner of the place on the other side is totally immutable and indisputable. So there is accessibility, permeability and also ubiquity in the global concept. So we have to understand the regional impact on the globe, the global impact on the regions and inter-regional impacts. If you study even your problem that is happening in Africa, even there is an engulfable endangering island, Bolo Island at Bangladesh or even at Mauritius and Maldives, certainly it is our neighborhood problem. Or even if you ponder that it's a universal vision, it is your domestic problem. Even if you ponder it more deeply, it is your internal problem. Even if you ponder it with more cosmopolitan vigilance and altruistic mentality, it is your personal problem. So, depending upon the range and depth of your identity with the global resources, we can just make even global things personal, and you can even just push away personal things as global if you are either a renounced person or irresponsible person. So, it is something connected. Before understanding which, unless we have this knowledge, then what is the role? See, somebody is doing something else there. Why we have been called and we have been discussing about something which is not going to do something at the dawn of tomorrow. So for that, it is a personal problem, and we are going to make, just as even in washrooms they have left a message that keep the toilet clean and leave it clean also to your forthcoming generations, not generations, travelers or passengers. The same thing is an indelible as well as assembled message for the cosmos, that we have to leave it as clean or more clean or at least clean to our forthcoming generations, without doing which it is disloyalty to nature, which according to Shastras, as well as to conscience, as well as to the ethics of survival and livelihood in the globe, where we have been getting all of the resources, it is totally against the rules. So it is disloyalty, it is brutalism, it is lesions at all. So we have to learn all of these things. So there are three major factors. One is the glacial factor, second is the oceanal variation factor, and third thing is the cyclic impact factor. The glacial factor is the primitive factor, as well as the primeval factor, as well as the prime factor, and also the primary factor. Glacial things, they amplify, they do not directly do things, but this glacial determination amplifies the climate change immediately. And there is a phenomenon known as glacial retreat. In summer, you know that the glaciers melt and they form water, and the interrelative phenomenon of melting as well as hardening that happens between summer and winter. So whenever the winter comes, it must be refrozen to the status. But according to the Climatic Conservation Society and their vigilant and meticulous observation of the previous century, this glacial retreat has been totally reduced. That is, the ability of the glaciers, which are melting down at the time of summer, to reorganize and refrozen their status in the form of glaciers, repatriation of the status, that has been reduced. The ability has been made disproportionate. So this has been observed. This is a very alarming incident that happens in the world. And third thing, since this ice age, there must be a regular study of the intergalaxial, as well as intergalactical, as well as galactical and galaxial study. One is on the surface, I told, galactical study. Second is galaxial study, that is a composite impact of constellations, meteors, galaxies, super galaxies, supernova and hypernova particles, various other planetary intermingled contributive composition, whatever it may be. These things are the major things that happen in the world. The first thing is very much understandable, scrutable. The second thing is easily not scrutable. They may require some sort of subtle perception. And this ice age, it clearly says what are the impacts that are happening in the various orbitary variations, as well as Earth's response to orbitary variations, and which has resulted in the understanding of your final consequence, which is nothing but rise and fall of continental ice sheets. Ice means it is not like the cup ice or the bulby ice that we are taking now. It is in a continental ice sheet. which is as systematic, which is as colossal, which is as nuclear as that of the plate tectonic system of the Earth's crust. So these type of continental hardcore crust ice sheets, the rise and fall has been totally subjected to confusion. The rise and fall due to the climatic change, their construction, integration, disintegration and reconstruction process has been collapsed. And there are a lot of scientific events which cannot be explained unless we organize a separate seminar, like the Hill Ridge event, Hasgard-Esger event, Young Gyros event. These things are scientific events which have been propounded as the consequential impact as well as counter impact of the glacial variations. Next we are coming to oceans. It is very much interesting and we have to learn these things. There are four major oscillations in oceans. And I have already told, even though oceans, they can affect only coastal areas as per the proclamation given by the people, they alarm the coastal area. Coastal area is instantaneous, immediate alarm. It does not mean that the non-coastal or district coastal people are safe and secure. It does not mean so. Socially, politically, geologically, economically, they will be affected. Immediately, we are going to discuss in the conclusive area. So, the first thing is the El Nino, the northern oscillation area. Second thing is the Pacific decadal oscillation. Third thing is northern Atlantic oscillation. Fourth thing is Arctic oscillation. These four things are the major oscillations of the oceanic systems. And there is an effect of the thermal energy to induce heat or to repatriate heat in the atmosphere, which is known as thermohaline effect. It can be very simply explained. There are two currents in oceans. One is the shallow warm current and second thing is the deep cold salty current. The sun's thermal energy, the solar thermal energy reflects in the shallow area, then it is conducted in between the various reservoirs, which are like shells and hives inside the oceanic tides, and they are just reconverted or repatriated to the atmosphere itself by means of the oceanic emission. So ocean repatriates the heat to the atmosphere, also observes these things. This type of cyclic impact is what we call thermohaline effect. It is absorbing heat and also setting the heat back to the atmosphere area. We all consider that water surfaces, just they absorb heat, they reduce heat and make us chill. It is not so. It is one side. So in the other side of the bidimensional impact of heat in the oceanic tides, absorption, retention, transmission and repatriation of the four, that is tetracyclic activities of the thermohaline effect. Third thing is the cyclic effect. Like vicious circles of poverty, it is the vicious circles of cyclic effect of climate change. For example, if an area is dry, immediately it does three impacts. One, it shrinks the already available wet area. It dries the semi-wet area. It enhances the dry area. If there is dryness, dryness creates three impacts. Dryness enhances dryness. Dryness reduces or shrinks the wetness. And dryness apparently dries the semi-wet areas, that is the marshy areas. So likewise, if this dryness is the impact of the society due to the climate change, then it will expand the deserts. The desert lands and the eroded lands, useless lands, non-arable lands, they are expanded. And number two, the plains, they are made dry, and water surfaces like natural reservoirs in the form of ponds, lakes, everything, they are shrunk. Like Samsara Sagara, that thing which was very deep and abysmal, that is just up to the knee level now. So this is the